refugee crisis. We don't see it. So I feel like that's a story that wants to be shared here. So that's kind of why I chose this play, besides the fact that I liked it and thought it was good. Something else about it, this play is about a young refugee that is looking to find his home, and in his home meaning his mother, okay? What I love about it is that it's a modern play by a playwright, an American, Japanese-American playwright woman, Naomi Iizuka, but it's based on Homer's Odyssey, which was written 2,800 years ago. So it's a really old story being retold for the current times, right? So, what was I gonna say? So an Odyssey, which is the story that Homer wrote, Greek, it was an epic poem, and the word Odyssey means a journey with hardships and obstacles. And that's what Homer's Odyssey is about. It's about Odysseus, who goes through all these hardships to find his way home after the Trojan War. So that's what the play's about. The style of this play is called magical realism. And magical realism is an art term, actually, in the 20s that describes realism and fantasy living together in the same work, right? And which we're used to now, because we have so many shows that have that concept. But there was a time where there was realism and there was fantasy, and they never connected, right? So that's the style that this show is, which means like goddesses can be with regular people, or there's unusual time shifts, moments where the unreal becomes real. And as an audience, we accept it because of the concept. So that's the style of this play. The way I've directed this play is in a Brechtian style. Bertolt Brecht was a theater maker, playwright, poet in the kind of turn of the century, 20s and 30s, really frustrated with the First World War and realistic theater. And he wanted to make theater that affected people. And so he had this technique or this effect called, and I'm not going to get this right because I don't speak German, but it's Verfremdungseffekt. And what Verfremdungseffekt means is like an estrangement effect. So it's like what he did was he took the lights and he didn't hide them and he put them out for people to see so that there was a distance, an emotional distance with the audience, so that the audience didn't get emotionally involved in the play. They actually were able to be objective and have an intellectual opinion about the social issues that he was bringing up in his theater. And his theater was called epic theater. So the connection with the Odyssey being an epic story from an epic poem and doing epic theater style, I thought would be really cool. So that's kind of why you see the actors at all times, you see the lights, you see the transitions, where in a lot of more naturalism theater, you don't see that, it's all hidden, okay? So that's a little bit about the play. I hope you enjoy it. I know that you'll be great audience members. These guys are working really hard and it's super close, so if you fart, we will hear you on stage, basically. So I appreciate it if you guys don't talk, or turn on any cell phones or anything like that. All right, awesome, thank you.
Come from as far away from here. Where I come from is oxen and rice fields and hills the color of green tea.
Where I come from is jungles filled with jaguars and pythons as thick as a grown man's thigh.
Where I come from is poison rocks and size of thumbnails and squirrels tall as palm trees.
There's olive trees and ancient deserts.
And sampans and temple bells.
It's sandstorms.
It's monsoon rains.
It's taper and okapi and electric blue butterflies. Wind
and
wide
and mango and
lemongrass.
Horchata.
Coconut milk.
Fried squid.
Cow's blood.
Sheep's milk, fresh and warm.
Where I come from is high up in the mountains, and the sound of thunder is so loud, it sounds like
the end of the world.
Where I come from is the edge of an ocean so blue, you can see straight to the bottom. And the sound of the waves crashing is so loud, it sounds like
the end of the world.
Where I come from, giant birds circle overhead. So many you can't count them all. They caw, caw, caw. And the sound they make is so loud, it sounds like
the end of the world.
Do you remember?
No.
All those memories.
I don't remember.
Can you hear them?
No.
You can't hear them? All those memories inside of you? You've locked them inside for so long, and now they're pounding against your ribcage, against the walls of your heart. Can you hear them?
Listen.
Sampans.
Monsoon rays.
Yerba mate.
Blue butterflies.
Lemongrass.
Bright papaya.
I don't know how to begin. I don't know where. I don't know where to begin.
Shh. Begin in the middle, on the border, on the crossing. Begin in the place in between.
Where I come from is far away from here. Where I come from, there was a war that lasted so long, people forgot what they were fighting for. Where I come from, bombs rained down from the sky night after night, and boys wandered the streets with M16s. Where I come from, mines are planted in the roads like deadly flowers, and the air smells like death, rank, and sticky sweet. Where I come from, you go to sleep at night and dream about the faces of the people you love. You dream the face of the one person you love, and that person becomes like home. Their eyes, their skin, their voice, the sound of their voice. And so you dream about that person. You dream about home. You dream about going home.
The first thing I want to say to you, Senator, is we are not a sweatshop.
We are the first stop on the way to the American dream. Give us your poor, your huddled masses yearning to be free, and we'll hire them, we'll give them a job, we'll put them to work. Nothing wrong with good, honest work. And as you can see, Senator, the conditions here are first rate. It's light and airy, modern, cheerful. Well, we have a great time, don't we, ladies? Well, all the ladies love me, and I love them.
Don't mind us, please, don't mind us. We're just here to observe.
What are you making?
Blue jeans, t-shirts, yoga pants, sports bras, boxer shorts, warm-up jackets, polo shirts, tube socks, short shorts, sweatshirts, khaki pants, baseball caps, mini skirts, baby bonnets, Oxford shirts, bikini tops.
Oh, I love this! What is it?
A shroud.
Check. Oh, a shroud! How interesting. Check. What's a shroud?
It's the sheet you wrap around the dead.
Oh, I see. Do you sell a lot of those shrouds, I mean?
It's not for sale.
It's lovely. The design is just lovely. I collect primitive art from all around the world. It's a passion of mine. I have baskets from Guatemala and little Buddhas from Cambodia. They speak to me. Speaks to me. I would love to buy it from you and hang it on my wall.
It's not for sale!
Don't mind Penny.
My name's not Penny.
Well, her real name is too hard to pronounce. We call her Penny. It's easier, isn't it, Penny?
Mr. Marcus wants to marry Penny. He proposes to her every day. Will you marry me, Penny? She whispers in her ear. He gets so close, she can smell his breath. Coffee and Kit Kat. She tells him she will say yes when she finishes the job.
I love Penny, and I want to give her a good home. She's had a very hard life, and I'm just doing my part. I have a very big heart. It's my undoing.
Mr. Marcus had a male order bride from Russia.
Not true.
And one from the Philippines.
Lies, lies, all lies.
And one from Thailand, Romania, and Honduras.
That's enough!
Who is it for? The shroud, I mean.
My son.
Your son? Is he dead? That's so sad.
That makes me very, very sad.
Helen, darling.
You must be devastated, you poor thing. How did you die?
He drowned.
He drowned? That's awful. It's so tragic. It's just so tragic. I feel your pain. I really do. How did it happen?
If you don't mind me asking.
Sure.
It helps sometimes to talk, you know, to share. That's sure. what human beings do. They share. They share their joy. They share their pain. It's only human. We're only human.
Check.
You can tell me. Go on. Tell me, and maybe I can help.
Where we come from, there was a war. And my son and me, we escaped. We escaped in the middle of the night. We sailed out to sea in an old fishing boat. There were so many people all crammed together. Old people and little babies. We huddled together in the dark, in the belly of the ship. We listened to the roar of the waves. We listened to the boat creak and moan. And then the storm started. The winds began to howl. The sky opened up and rain came down, sheets and sheets of rain. The lightning lit up the sky, bright, bright light, and the thunder crashed, and the sound was so loud. And suddenly, a giant wave rose up. It rose and it rose like a wall of water. And then it fell over us and swallowed us whole.
Someday, I'm going to sail away.
No, you're not. Don't be silly. You're not going anywhere. This is your home now.
It's not my home.
Yes, it is.
It's not my real home.
Yes, it is. Now look at me. Look at me. Smile. I said smile. You're very photogenic. You could be a male model. You're so swarthy and exotic. That's very in right now. Exotic is very in. I wish I could be more exotic. I'm too pale. I wish I had a tan. I wish my skin was the color of cafe au lait. Oh, I love this song. Do you want to watch TV? We can watch TV on my giant flat screen plasma TV. It's so cool. It's so flat.
No thanks.
How about a snack? I have M&M's and Kit Kats and Nestle Crunch and Reese's Pieces and Charleston Chews and Sweet Tarts and Lemonheads and Skittles and Spree.
I'm not hungry.
Suit yourself. We could do something else. We could kiss. You can kiss me. Do you want to kiss me?
No.
That's okay. You can kiss me later.
I'm never going to kiss you.
Fine.
Not now or later. Not ever.
Fine. Why are you so mean to me? You should be nice to me. I saved your life. You washed up on the shore at my dad's luxury beachfront condo, and you weren't even breathing. I pushed seaweed out of your mouth. I administered CPR and gave you the kiss of life, just like I learned at summer camp. And I thought you were so handsome and exotic, and not like any of the boys from around here. I saved your life and you're so ungrateful. You won't even tell me your real name.
I told you my real name.
Your real name's not Nobody. What kind of mom names are kid Nobody?
Don't talk about my mom.
I mean, I'm sure she was nice and all, but it's not even like she's part of your life anymore. I mean, she's probably dead. And even if she were alive, it's not like she's been trying that hard to find you. Honestly, if you want my opinion, she's probably moved on with her life. I know I would. I bet if you showed up on her doorstep, like, right this second, she wouldn't even know who you were. She'd be like, who are you? Do I know you?
I said don't talk about my mom! Okay, look, I can't stay here anymore. I can't do it.
Why not? It's nice here. It's pretty and clean. I have a satellite TV.
I'm gonna lose my mind if I stay here one more day.
Where would you go?
Home.
This is your home.
My real home.
Your real home?
That's crazy. Your real home's a dirty little third world shack with no running water. It's raw sewage in the streets, and malaria, and cholera, and all kinds of disgusting parasites I don't even want to think about. I'm just saying it how it is. Don't be mad. Now you're mad. Let's kiss and make up.
No.
Why not?
Because I hate you, and every time you open your mouth, I want to stuff sand down your throat.
Okay, you know what? I don't care. I don't care what you think. I don't care what you want. You will eat my Skittles and my Kit Kats and my treats. You will enjoy my flat screen plasma TV, and you will love me.
Hey.
Hey.
Remember me?
Yeah, kinda.
Where did you come from?
He called me.
I did?
He sent telepathic brainwaves out into the universe, and I was listening.
You were?
I was. I'm a really, really good listener.
That's cool.
I know.
That's really cool.
I know.
Excuse me? Who are you?
I'm a goddess. And you are?
I live here. My dad owns this place. He has everything as far as the eye can see. He is very, very powerful. That's who I am.
Is that supposed to impress me?
I'm just saying it how it is.
You know, you're like really pale.
Yeah, well, you're like really rude.
Yeah, but you're really pale. How does a person get to be so pale? You're like Wonder Bread. You're like mayonnaise.
I'm not like mayonnaise. Cow.
Hag.
Witch. This is a private beach, so you better just take a hike.
You can't own a beach.
Yes, you can. My dad does. My dad owns this beach and the whole entire ocean.
That's the stupidest thing I've ever heard. That's like saying you own a jungle or a mountain range.
My dad owns some of those too. My dad is very rich.
Yeah? Well, if he's so rich, maybe he can buy you a better bathing suit, because that bathing suit is ugly.
Shut up!
It's like the ugliest bathing suit I've ever seen.
Shut up!
So you want to go or what?
Like now?
Like right now, like right this second.
He's not going anywhere. He's not allowed.
He's not allowed? Who says?
My dad. My dad says we have to stay inside our luxury gay community. My dad says it's dangerous out there. My dad says all these foreigners are flooding in with their strange customs and their weird food, and they don't speak English, and they're not like us. Most of them are illegal. They're illegal aliens. That's what my dad says. Whenever he says that, I think of little green men in spacesuits. But not that kind of alien he means. He means a different kind of alien.
You're an idiot.
Shut up.
And your dad's an even bigger idiot.
My dad's not an idiot. My dad is really, really rich and really, really powerful, and you do not want to make him mad.
Look, I don't care about your dad. I don't care what he thinks or says or does. I don't listen to people like your dad. And he doesn't either, right?
Right.
Ready?
Yeah.
Wait, you can't go.
Yeah, I can. Watch me.
Wait! Stop! Come back! I'm gonna call my dad and then you're going to be sorry!
Last time I was in the ocean, I almost drowned.
I know.
I was with my mom. We were in an old fishing boat. We were trying to escape, and there was a storm.
I know.
How could you know that?
You don't remember me, do you?
Yeah, I do. Oh, we knew each other when we were kids.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. He lived across the street.
Is that right?
He lived in a big old building. It's not there anymore. The bombs fell and was destroyed.
I know. What was I like?
Kind of shy. Kind of cute. Your hair was different.
Shorter? Longer?
Just different. I had a crush on you.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I think you're thinking of someone else.
Maybe. Okay, I think I remember now. You were this girl at the airport.
Yeah?
Yeah, you were waiting to get on a plane. You were all by yourself. You were going somewhere far away. You were reading a book.
What book?
It was a big book. I remember it was like this. Really big, really old book. The title is on the tip of my tongue.
You don't remember me.
No. Not really, but I feel like I do. I feel like I know you. I feel like I've known you my whole life.
That's because I'm a goddess and I come to you in your dreams.
Really?
Uh-huh. And you're a mere mortal, so you don't remember. Your brain's too small.
Is that how it works?
Pretty much.
And what do, like when you come to me in my dreams?
I give you advice. I whisper it in your ear. Sometimes I save your life.
Is that right?
Uh-huh.
Do all goddesses kiss like that?
No, just me.
I'm really homesick.
I know.
It's like a big, empty room inside of me.
I know.
What if you want to go home, but there's no more home to go home to? What if the one person you love more than anything, what if they don't remember you? What if they don't even know who you are?
Okay, no more kissing. You have things to do.
Like what?
Like survive the storm.
Why does there always have to be a storm? Why can't it just be smooth sailing?
Don't ask why. Just start swimming.
Wait!
And your little boy, did you ever see him again?
No.
Sometimes I think maybe he was saved. Maybe the Coast Guard found him, or maybe he was able to swim to shore.
Wouldn't that be something?
And then maybe he was adopted by a nice American family.
Yes! We adopted the little boy from the third world. The senator and I found him in a refugee camp. He was so cute, and we had such high hopes. But it didn't work out. He was nothing but problems from the start. He didn't blend in, he had a bad attitude, and then he ran away. Can you believe it? We gave him everything and he ran away.
I think maybe my son, maybe he's alive somewhere.
Maybe, probably not, but maybe.
Helen, darling, we really have to scoot.
I hope it all works out for you, I really do.
Helen!
I mean, I hope you can find closure and renewal. I find meditation and yoga. Yoga can be really helpful. Mindfulness and deep breathing.
Helen!
Coming, darling!
I got some takeout for the two of us. It's from this little Indian place on the other side of town. I got us a little chicken tiki masala, a little papadum, a little naan. Tastes.
I'm not hungry.
Marry me, you little vixen, you little minx!
Mr. Macus!
You know you want to marry me. You find me irresistible.
Mr. Macus, please.
You know, this plain hard-to-get Penny is really getting old. You either marry me or lose your job. I hate to be so blunt, but that's just the way things are.
As I have told you, in my homeland, it is customary
it is customary to make a shroud in which to bury the dead.
That is correct.
Yes, but you're not dead and I'm not dead. We're alive, Penny. We're vital. We have needs and desires. We have appetites.
Mr. Macus!
Oh!
When I am done, we can get married.
Well, can't you speed things up?
It takes as long as it takes.
What if I can't wait?
Then you will incur the wrath of the gods. Bad luck like you have never seen before. Forget about the number 13. Forget about breaking a mirror or stepping on a crack. Do you want to tempt fate, Mr. Macus? Do you know what happens to mortals who tempt fate? Vultures! Pecking at your liver and eyeballs for all eternity. Your arms and legs ripped loose from their sockets. Your head pried loose from its neck. Your skull smashed against a rock. Brain goo splattered all over the pavement.
Fine! No need to agitate the gods. My little crab apple. My little peach pit. I'll wait. I can wait. Sweet dreams, my little sweet potato. Scare you.
You didn't scare me.
You look kind of scared.
Well, I'm not.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
You shouldn't be hanging out in dark alleys in the middle of the night. It's dangerous.
I don't care. I'm strong.
You don't look that strong.
Well, I am.
It's okay. I mean, you'd be okay no matter what. I'd protect you.
I don't need protecting.
Right, because you're strong.
That's right. I am.
I believe you. You have a nice voice.
No, I don't.
Nazrin!
I like that song you were singing.
It's old. The kind of stuff my mom listens to. My mom has a nice voice. She sings. I don't sing.
Nazrin!
What's your name?
Kuri.
I've never heard that name before. What does it mean?
Quick thinking.
Is it stinky in there?
Kinda, but the food's pretty good.
What food? That's not food. That's garbage.
What makes it garbage?
It's in the garbage can.
Yeah, but it's the same food. It's just in a different setting.
Sometimes the customers order all this food, and then they take just one bite, and they say it's too spicy. So then they send it back, and we have to throw it away.
I like spicy.
Me too. The hotter, the better.
Nazreen!
Nazreen, what are you up to? Your mother has been calling and calling. Are you conversing with the cockroaches? What do the cockroaches have to say for themselves this evening? Perhaps they say, hello, Nazreen, how are you? Did you bring me some leftover curry or a few morsels of naan? You're very pungent, Mr. Cockroach. Smell whiff of our aloo gobi from last week. Scent of our chicken korma from just yesterday. Right there is our mouth-watering lamb sog. I have an excellent sense of smell. Do you speak?
Yeah.
A very large cockroach endowed with the gift of speech.
I'm not a cockroach.
Good. That's good. My wife kills cockroaches. She crushes them with a shoe.
His name is Kuri.
Kuri?
Look, I should probably go.
I'm Ollie.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Ollie,
not
but...
Not Mr. Ollie, just Ollie. This is my lovely daughter, Nazreen, whom you've already met. I am the proprietor of this establishment, and my wife, Ritu, is the chef. Each dish she makes is a masterpiece. Sense of home in each delicious bite.
Look, I really gotta go.
You will be our guest.
That's really nice of you, but I can't. I really have to get going.
I insist. It's more comfortable indoors. This way, please.
No, no. See, I can't do that. I can't stay.
Nonsense. Nazreen, set the table. We too. We have company.
So hot! It's hot, hot, hot! So hot I want to cry!
Allie, you're going to give yourself a bellyache.
Nonsense, I can take it.
Allie, stop! You're going to keel over.
It's pepper. It makes me sweat. It's very healthy.
You're turning red like a beet. Tell me this is healthy.
Very healthy.
It's so little.
Don't be fooled. It's the hottest pepper of them all.
Enough is enough. You eat that pepper, your tongue will fall right out of your mulish old head.
What about our guest, Papa? Maybe he wants to try.
No, no, that's okay.
I thought you said you liked spicy.
I do.
Well, then here you go.
Nazreen.
He said he liked spicy. That's what he said. Isn't that what you said?
Nazreen, my dove, there's spicy, then there's spicy. I think our guest is wise enough to know the difference.
I think he's scared.
I'm not scared. How bad can it be?
Bad.
A burning inferno.
The Death Star of peppers.
Well?
He did it.
Impressive, stranger. I'm impressed.
I used to have a goat that could eat anything. Tin cans, hubcaps, hot peppers.
You did? What happened to him?
I chopped him up and made him goat stew.
We do.
Where do you come from, stranger?
I'm from all over.
And your family, where are they?
I don't know. I'm not sure.
I see. And what was your name again? I don't think I caught it.
Nobody. I mean, Kuri. I mean, nobody. I mean, Kuri.
Kuri or nobody? Which is it?
Nobody. I'm nobody.
Cooking for nobody, am I? That seems like a waste of perfectly good food.
Me too. Please.
You're too trusting, Ali. The sea is full of liars and thieves. We don't know him. We don't know where he comes from. We don't know anything about him.
She's right. I should go. I'm really sorry.
No, you are a guest. Ritu has just had a long day. Please forgive her.
Ritu has had a many long days. Ritu has had a many long weeks and months and years. And Ritu can speak for herself. Here, I cooked it. You might as well eat it.
Thanks. Thank you. Cumin, cinnamon, nutmeg, turmeric, allspice, cardamom, fennel, cloves, coriander.
Yes, coriander. How did you know that?
My mom used the same spices. She just put them together differently.
Where is she now?
I don't know.
How can you not know where your mom is?
Where I come from, there was a war. There was a war and lots of people disappeared.
You mean they died?
Nazreen?
Some of them, but some of them they just disappeared.
Maybe they escaped.
Maybe.
Maybe your mom escaped. Maybe she's living in the city somewhere and you just don't know it because she changed her name. But she's looking for you too. Only she doesn't know where to look because she came here from somewhere else. So she doesn't know how to get around. Lots of people come here from someplace else. We did. Where we came from, there was a war too.
Nazreen!
That's how my dad became blind. There was a bomb in the marketplace. Lots of people died. Old people and little children.
Nazreen, that's enough. That was before. We don't talk about that now.
I don't remember where we came from. I was just a baby when we left.
Oh, you remember. You just don't remember that you remember.
How can I remember what I don't remember?
Sometimes, in your dreams, something will bubble up from the depths. A tiny flicker of something you thought you forgot. A taste, or a scent.
Jasmine.
Yes, jasmine. Your mother used to wear jasmine blossoms in her hair. Come across that scent sometimes. All of a sudden, I can think of something from years before, like a shining coin at the bottom of a well.
What do you remember?
I don't know where to begin. I don't know how. I don't know how to begin.
Begin in the middle, on the border, on the crossing. Begin in the place in between.
I remember my mom. How she used to hold me. She held me when the bombs fell. She held me when the ground shook and the city burned. She held me on the night that we escaped. She held me in the belly of a boat as we sailed across a giant sea. I remember how she held me. And then one night there was a terrible storm. The next thing I remember, I was floating in the giant ocean. In the distance, I could see tiny lights. I started to swim towards them. I swam even though my clothes were soaked through, even though my arms and legs were numb, even though it hurt to breathe. I swam and I swam. I swam until I couldn't swim anymore, and then everything went black. Wake up! Wake up! Quick! Come on! They won't come after us here.
Who were they?
Police, INS, rent-a-cop, who knows?
Where are we?
Tunnel.
What's that sound?
Rats. Giant rats. 5 foot long, nose to tail. They live down here. They go in packs, and when they find you alone and sleeping, they attack. They tear out your insides. They rip out your guts. They tear out your still beating heart.
Didn't know rats came that big.
You don't believe me?
No.
Liar, you're scared. I can see it in your eyes.
I'm not scared.
Yeah, you are. You ran like a little girl just now.
Then that makes two of us.
Come again.
I said that makes two of us, little girl.
I am not a little girl.
No, you're right. You're just a liar.
What did you say to me?
You heard me, liar. Why did you help me? Before, I mean.
I don't know. I guess you looked like you needed some help.
Thanks.
Whatever. Hungry?
Yeah.
Where'd you learn English?
My mom. She taught me.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'm Pascal.
I'm Lan.
Lan, huh?
Yeah, Lan.
Didn't nobody ever tell you it's rude to stare?
Sorry.
Where I come from, they cut your face when you turn 13. Like a warrior. You got any scars?
No.
Everybody got scars. Maybe yours you just can't see. Don't! He don't hurt no one. He lives down here.
What's wrong with him?
What's wrong with him? He's high. He's high as a kite.
Looks like someone I know.
Could be. He won't remember if he is. His brain is fried. He don't remember nothing. He don't remember where he comes from. He don't remember his family. He don't remember the names of his kids. All he thinks about is getting high.
Must be lonely.
Oh, he ain't alone. He got lots of company.
Right on time! Come on, Lantern, whatever your real name is! You stay down there, you're gonna get squashed like a pancake! You think I'm fooling? You watch and see! Listen. You know, you kind of look like a monkey.
I don't look like a monkey.
Yeah, you do. Around the chin and the ears. You got monkey ears. What's wrong with monkeys?
I don't look like a monkey.
Monkeys are good luck. Relax, monkey.
How far does this thing go?
Far.
We could keep going and going.
We could, but we won't. We got a destination.
Oh yeah? Where's that?
Place I hear we can get some work, get some money, get set up, get some new clothes. You monkey are in need of new clothes.
What would you do if you had all the money in the world?
Well, first I'd buy a brand new car, so I could go anywhere in style. Nice, shiny rims, a nice sound system so I could listen to my tunes. And then I'd eat all I could eat. Steak, French fries, pizza. That's my favorite. Pepperoni pizza.
What about you?
I don't know.
Yeah, you do.
I don't know.
Guess I'd buy my mom a house.
You know, a big house with a big yard so she'd never have to worry. So she'd always have some place she could go. You know, home.
A home, huh? That's nice. That's cool.
Do you believe in fate?
Like fortune telling?
Kinda. Like everything that happens to you is decided before you're even born.
And you don't have a choice.
No choice.
I don't know. I guess I don't think about stuff like that.
Where I come from, they try to tell you your future from the stars.
Oh yeah? What do my stars say?
They say you'll, go far and have a bumpy ride.
You know what? I knew that already.
The stars don't lie.
No. You're just telling me what I already know.
Look at them. So many stars. They look exactly the way they do at home.
You think about home?
Oh, not so much. How about you?
I think about my mom sometimes.
Yeah? What's she like?
I don't know how to describe her. Like a mom.
Does she smell like soap?
Yeah, like soap and clean clothes and some kind of flour. I don't know what it is.
Does she have an enormous bag? She carries everything in.
Uh-huh.
And her eyes crinkle up when she laughs.
Yeah.
And she sings to herself when she thinks no one's listening.
Uh-huh.
Does she chop vegetables really, really fast?
So fast you can't even believe it. Yeah.
Does she sew?
Uh-huh.
And when she sews, the stitches are so tiny and even you wonder, how can they be so
perfect?
Yeah. I think about my mom, too.
Where's she now?
We're almost there!
Pascal, where's your mom? Where is she now?
You know how to jump?
You know how to fall? Watch!
I'll show you!
Good sausage is one of life's great pleasures. Do you like sausage? Here, for you. You like that? It's my secret recipe, top secret. How about you, sausage? Don't you like sausage? No? No matter. More for me and your friend, then.
We're looking for work.
What kind of work?
Anything you've got.
Times are tight, as you see. It's just me now. I had to let everyone else go.
Oh, we're good workers. We can do anything. Anything you need. Pascal! Pascal!
What?
I could use some help cleaning up. I make a mess. My line of work.
We could do that. How much?
Trust me, I'll do right by you. What's the matter with your friend? Cat got his tongue?
What kind of meat is that?
Brain. It's a delicacy. High in protein. Very rich. Fried up a little garlic. Very tasty.
Where do we start?
There's a bucket and some sponges. I want you to scrub, scrub, scrub. I'll be back.
Look at this thing.
Look at how sharp it is.
Leave it.
It's cold.
Don't complain. We make some money, and then we go.
How do we know he's gonna pay us?
Oh, he'll pay. Before you know it, we'll have enough money. We can go anywhere. We can do whatever we want.
I don't like this place.
It's just a job. You think too much.
Maybe you don't think enough.
Maybe you should just shut up.
What's in there?
Feed my little bird? Oh, I have a little pet bird. I feed her little morsels from my hand. She's very tame. I coo to her, and she coos back. This is my freezer. It's very cold. Aren't you cold? I have to keep it cold like this, or else the meat gets bad. Look at all this meat. Isn't it strange? When you cut off the head, when you scrape off the skin, when you boil away the fat and gristle, it's hard to tell what something was. Was it a cow? Or a pig? Or a goat? Was it a little baby lamb? Or was it something else? A different kind of meat. Fleshy and tender and vaguely familiar. Do you know what goes into my sausages? Do you know what makes them so mouth-wateringly delicious? Do you have an idea? The tiniest inkling. What? Cat got your tongue?
Where's my friend?
What friend?
His name is Pascal.
He was here.
He was standing right here just a second ago.
There's nobody here named Pascal. You must be confused. There's only you and me and my little pet bird.
He was standing right here.
What was your name again? I don't think you ever said.
Monkey.
Monkey. How delightful. You do look a little like a monkey. One of those worried little monkeys you see in a zoo. They look like little old men nibbling on a piece of fruit, scratching at their fleas, racing around their cages looking for a way out. Except, of course, there is no way out. What a noisy bird. I used to have two of them. One of them, he flew away. Now I keep the door shut tight. Or else she'll fly away too. And then I'll be all alone. Be quiet, bird, or I'll cook you in a pot. How do you like your meat, monkey? Well done or rare? Oh, I like my meat rare. How about a glass of wine? Oh, yes. A glass of wine would be delightful. Only, I have to tell you, I'm a little tired of Cabernets. I prefer a Chianti. A Chianti can be just the thing.
I don't know much about wine.
No?
No.
Well, why would you? It's just wine.
I've always wanted to learn.
Really?
I just never knew anyone who knew anything about wine. Oh. Not like yourself.
Some people are such snobs about wine. My feeling is, you like what you like. There's no right or wrong. There's only what you like. Here, I'll show you. Now here we have a lovely vintage. Full-bodied, robust. Twirl it. See how it streaks? That's what it should do. That's exactly what it should do. And then we sniff. And now we taste. Oaky. Fine wine is one of life's great pleasures. It's civilized. We live in nasty, brutish times. I try to remember what it is to be civilized. Linen napkins, opera, fine wine. Because it means something. It matters. But sometimes it can be so lonely. It can be so very lonely. You have no idea. It's nice to have someone to share a glass of wine with. I'll miss you when you go.
Go?
Thwack, thwack. Sausage doesn't grow on trees. Sorry, monkey. That's just the way it is. And then it'll be me and my little bird. My little bird, she keeps me company.
but she's sad. She had a baby bird once, but he flew away.
Maybe if you left the door open, he'd fly back.
Oh, you're very tricky. But if I open the door, you'll run away, my little sausage-to-be.
Shh, listen. I think I hear a bird outside.
No bird.
I swore I heard a bird just now. There. Listen.
Was that a bird? Cheep, cheep, cheep. I feel so very, very sleepy. Oh, my eye, what have you done to my eye? I can't see anything. My eye, it's killing me. Little bird, is that you?
Who's that? How does that taste? Is it full body? Is it robust? Is it civilized enough for you?
Way to go. Say something. Why don't you say something?
He cannot. My name is Belen. What's your name?
Nobody. I'm nobody. Do I know you? I feel like I know you.
Maybe from a past life. Do you remember me from a past life?
I don't remember.
When you die, this you forget. You forget where you come from. You forget the people you love. That's what dying means. To forget. So you have to try very hard to remember. You have to keep what you love right in front of you, like a shiny coin at the bottom of a well.
By the sister I love.
I need to get back. I need to find my way back. I need to find my way back home.
Where's home?
Far away.
How far?
Far, very far. What's he saying?
He says we should go now. He says we'll die if we stay here. He says we're lucky. A truck will come by and we can get a ride. He says I should go with you. He says you'll protect me. Papa, wait!
Why doesn't he come with us?
He would, if he could.
Why can't he?
Well, my father left our village. He promised to come back and get me. He never made it. He died on his way back. Don't you see? My father is a ghost.
Never used to be this hot. It's the ozone. The ozone's all messed up. So where are you kids headed?
Home.
Home, sweet home. That's nice. So where's home? Far away, I'm guessing. What's the matter? Cat got your tongue?
What did you say?
What? Cat got your tongue? It's just something my dad used to say.
Your dad? Who is your dad?
Why do you care? He wasn't nobody, just some mean old drunk. Owned a butcher shop out in the boonies, had one good eye. Can you believe it? He liked to listen to opera. If there's one thing I can't stand, it's opera. I hate opera. So, what you got there, girlie? Diamonds? Rubies? State secrets?
Hey!
Ooh, what? Calm down. I was just picking a little piece of lint off the little lady's dress. Just a little piece of fuzz. Hot, huh? I'm sweating like a pig.
What's that sound?
It could be the muffler.
What's in back? What are you hauling?
This and that. It's a cash business. I don't ask a lot of questions.
I can hear something. There.
Words the wise, pal. Keep your nose out of where it doesn't belong.
I think we should stop. I think we should stop and check.
Look, I already stopped for you and your little friend here out of the goodness of my heart. I'm not stopping again. I'm already running late. You're very pretty. Anybody ever tell you that? You got pretty hair. This clown, he's not your boyfriend, is he? He can't be. You're too young to have a boyfriend. You're real quiet, aren't you? I like that. I can't stand girls who yak and won't shut up. I like quiet girls. You speak English? I'll teach you to speak English.
I hear someone. Somebody's back there. Who's back there?
Nobody.
There's people back there. How many people are back there?
None of your business, pal.
I say it's too hot. They'll suffocate. Stop the truck.
You gotta be kidding me.
I said stop the truck.
No.
What are you doing? Are you out of your mind?
Pull over.
No.
What are you doing?
I said pull over.
Are you insane?
My name was Maria. I came to America on a ship.
My name was Amet. I came to America in a truck.
My name was Suchai. I walked 1,000 miles.
I crossed the giant desert.
My name was Aram. It was so cold, my fingers froze.
My name was Tian. I always traveled in the night.
My name was Marcella. I was afraid.
My name was Sahis. I made no sound.
My name was Pran. I was invisible.
My name was Malik. I was like the murmuring wind.
My name was John Su. I was the edge of a shadow.
My name was Fatima. I was flicker out of the corner of
your eye. My name was Yusuf. I came here to make a better life.
My name was Said. I had so many dreams.
My name was Miguel.
My
I
name
died.
Was Trin. I died
my
along the way.
My name was Faisal. Tell my sister.
My name is Mina. Please tell my brother.
My name was Abraham.
Name
tell
son,
my father.
Tell my
name
mother.
Is Joseph. Tell my,
my
son.
My name is Alicia. Tell my daughter.
Remember me. Remember me. Remember me.
Well, look at what the cat dragged in. Welcome to the last stop, stranger. The end of the road. Rock bottom. Come on in. Make yourself at home. We're all friends here. The more the merrier, right?
Water! Please, can I have a glass of water?
I'm gonna have to charge you for that sugar. You know that, right?
I don't have any money.
No money? You come in here and ask me for a drink and you don't have any money? What? Does it look like I'm running some kind of charity? Is that what it looks like to you? He thinks I'm running a charity. Never mind. Take it. Just take it. It's on the house. What happened to you? You get in a fight?
No. It wasn't like that.
What was it like?
I don't want to talk about it.
You got someplace to go?
No.
You're just a kid. You should go home. Just go on home.
I don't have a home. I don't have a family. I don't have that. I don't have anyone.
Hey, hey, hey. It's okay. It's all right.
It hurts. It's like all these bad things keep happening to me and there's nothing I can do. It's like everyone I get close to, they all go away. It's like they all go away and there's nothing I can do.
Shh. You're getting yourself all worked up. You gotta just let it go. Just let it go. Dance with me. Why don't you dance with me?
I gotta go.
You don't wanna go. Just stay. Stay a while. You can stay here as long as you want. You can stay here forever.
Hey! Hey, wait, come back! Hey! Hey, I want to talk to you. Hey! Belen? Belen, is that you? Belen, wait! A skull? Where I come from, soldiers came to my village.
I saw them coming and I ran into the forest and hid beneath the leaves. I was so still I could hear everything. I could hear the sound of fire and men shouting. I could hear my little brother. I could hear him crying and I could hear my mother saying, "Don't cry, don't cry." I could hear the sound of machetes and I could hear their screams. Then it was quiet. It was so quiet. All I could hear was my heart beating. Will you remember me,
Pascal?
When you're old and you look back, will you remember me? Will you remember a friend who died long ago?
Pascal. Pascal, wait!
I disappeared.
I became invisible.
I ran away.
I escaped.
I shed my skin.
I changed my name.
I became anonymous.
My name is anonymous. My name is anonymous. My name is anonymous.
My name is anonymous. My name is anonymous. My name is anonymous.
I lost a star, I lost.
There was a war. There was a war, and my mom and I, we escaped. We escaped on a boat. And there was a storm, and that boat we were on sank, and lots of people drowned. I know this for a fact. And then later, I was in a refugee camp, and I was adopted by a nice American family. These are facts. They lived in a fancy house full of so many things, but they weren't my family, and it wasn't my home. So I ran away. That's a fact, too. These are all facts, but facts are only part of the story. I think your life is made up of all these bits and pieces. Sometimes the pieces don't quite fit together. There's a piece that's missing. And so you try to remember, try to fill in the blanks. You can see something you can almost make out. You can almost see a face.
Your mother's face.
Yes.
There's a place I know, on the other side of town. I worked there when we first came to this country. I sewed clothes, blue jeans, t-shirts. It was a terrible place.
It's a sweatshop. They should have shut it down years ago. All those women from all those different countries from all around the world. Ari too?
Yes, Ali, yes.
What are you saying?
It's a small world, stranger. Smaller than you think.
You think my mother? That's crazy.
Is it?
What are the chances? One in a million?
What have you got to lose? There is no way to know unless you go and see. You've come this far. Trust me, I have an idea. Nazreen, put the rice on. Ali, get the ghee. Now listen to me. Listen to me carefully.
Lies, lies, lies. I've had it with your lies.
Check.
You tell me you're gonna marry me when the shroud is done.
Check.
But it's never going to be done, is it? Is it?
Check.
Because you undo it in the night when no one's looking, except
Check.
For Vanna here, who happened to see what you're up to and had the decency
Check.
To tell me. And thank you, Vanna. But as for you,
Check.
You deceitful, duplicitous, mendacious minx, your little charade is over. We're getting married now. No more stalling. No more delay. Who are you?
Check.
What do you want? Why are you here?
Somebody ordered takeout.
Who? Not me. I've already eaten, and they don't eat.
Check.
Well, not when I eat. But I don't know when they. That's not my concern. Why am I telling you all this? Why am I even talking to you? I don't have to explain myself. Where do you think you're going? We have things to do. We're gonna get married, and then we're gonna live happily ever after. Happy, happy, happy. The end.
Leave her alone.
What did you say to me?
You heard me.
Is someone talking to me? I think it must be a fly that is buzzing around my head. But it's not a fly. It's you. And who are you again? I'll tell you who you are. You're nobody. You're a tiny cockroach I squash with my hand. You're a piece of lint I flick off my jacket. You're chewing gum on the bottom of my shoe. You're faceless and nameless, and you're a dime a dozen people like you. Stop it! Be still!
You're hurting me!
Be
still!
Leave her alone!
Leave her alone. That's funny. You're funny. You're a funny, funny guy! Make me, little fly!
Okay, if you insist.
Kill me! Please don't kill me! What was your name? Stranger friend? I don't think I caught it.
Call me Anonymous.
Where I come from is far away from here.
It's Oxen in rice fields.
It's hills the color of green tea.
Filled with jaguars.
And pythons as thick as a grown man's thigh.
And poison frogs the size of a thumbnail.
And squirrels that fly from tree to tree.
And waterfalls taller than the tallest skyscraper.
It's olive trees and ancient deserts.
It's song ponds and temple bells.
It's sandstorms.
It's monsoon rain.
It's tapir and okapi. And electric blue butterflies with wings as wide as my arms. Where I come from, there are butterflies like nothing you've ever seen.
Blue.
Yes, blue, so blue.
With huge wings.
Huge.
Like this, bigger even.
Yes. Yes.
I remember. What if I told
you? No, don't say it.
But what if somehow?
Don't.
What if?
I don't believe in what if. What if will break your heart?
You have a son.
My son died. He died a long time ago. He was just a little boy and he died.
What if he didn't?
Stop.
What if he survived?
I said stop.
Please listen to
me. No. No. I can't. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
What do you remember? Because what I remember is you. I remember how you held me, how you sang to me. I remember the song you sang to me.
How can I know you are who you say you are?
I'll tell you the story of my life, and then you can decide. It begins in the middle, on the border, on the crossing. It begins in the place in between.